expected this to be the time of our lives.
Guys, are you ready to party? Chicago!
Get the f*** out.
You do understand that this would be the first episode of Real World where someone gets, like, killed, right?
I was right. I feel so guilty.
This sucks. I don't think I want to be here anymore. But to give up? Is that dumb? What's even keeping me here, man? The thought of what would happen if I return home, and that'd be humiliating. But the fear of quitting the show makes me a coward.
Olivia!
Oh, hello, my fair goddess.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good.
I have your necklace. I want to give it back to you.
I never gave that to you.
Yes, you did. You did, but you're an ass.
Are you for real?
Yes.
Seriously?
Yes.
Well, screw you!
You used to be so smart and strong. What happened?
He isn't crazy for love, but he is crazy. Whatever is bothering him is threatening me.
We heard everything. I'll listen to him when he speaks to his mother tonight, and if he still confesses nothing, then we'll send him away.
Yes, madness of great ones must not go unwatched. You know what, Harvey? You're the best man I've ever known. And I'm not saying this to flatter you. You're just so calm and ready for whatever life throws at you. You know, the movie is exactly what happened to my father. So during the movie tonight, you keep a close eye on Claude. His reaction will tell all.
I will watch him closely.
Hello, Hank. How's it going?
Wonderful. Paula, you were an actor once, weren't you?
Yes, I was. People thought I was a good actor, too.
Everyone's leaving. Let's go.
No, I'm gonna sit next to a prettier lady. May I sit in your lap?
No.
I meant put my head in your lap.
Yes.
Do you think I was implying something?
I think nothing.
That's a nice thought.
What is?
Nothing.
You're in a good mood tonight.
Who, me?
Yes.
You know what? You know how I feel about this? It makes me sick to see my mom floundering around and my dad's only been gone for 2 weeks.
Claude is getting up.
Is everything all right?
Just give me some lights.
Turn it off. Turn on the lights. Give us some lights.
Harvey, did you see it? He must be guilty.
Yes, I did see it.
Oh, that was marvelous.
Hey, Hank. Claude is very upset.
With drinks, sir?
No, he's angry.
Why are you telling this to me?
Your mother's upset, too. She wants to see you. She's very astonished with your behavior lately.
What wonderful son that can astonish a mother. But there is no sequel to this mother's admiration. Impart.
She wants to speak with you before you go to bed.
Sure.
Are you sure there's nothing bothering you? I mean, nothing's been going on lately?
Do you think I'm so easily manipulated?
She wants to speak with you right away.
Oh, look at that cloud up there. It looks like a weasel.
Totally like a weasel.
Like a camel.
Definitely like a camel.
Or like a whale.
Totally.
Tis now the very witching time of night, when churchyards yawn and the hell itself breathes out, and I do such bitter business in a bitter day, would quake to look on. Soft now to my mother, O heart, lose not thy nature. Let on ever the soul of Nero enter this firm bosom. Let me be cruel, but not unnatural. I will speak daggers, but use none. How in my words, some ever she be sent, to give them seals never my soul consent. It's not safe for me to be around Hank.
I'm sending you with him to England.
I'll do anything you say.
I did it. I'm guilty. My guilt is stronger than my intent. Like, how can I ever be forgiven? Should I pray? But I cannot be, since I am still possessed of these effects for which I have done my sin. Can a person still be forgiven yet live with the fruits of his crime? Offense's gilded hand may shove my justice, but no, not in heaven. I suppose I could repent. That can hurt. But it wouldn't really help me either. Perhaps everything might turn out okay anyways.
Here's my chance to send him away so easily. But no, that's too easy. I want to leave him broken, crushed. I'll wait until he's in the midst of some unforgettable sin. That's when I'll do it.
My words fly up, my thoughts remain below. Words without thoughts never to heaven go.
He's coming. Make sure you tell him he's been causing too much trouble. I'll be right here. Pray you be round with him.
Mom! Mom!
I'll do what you say. Now withdraw.
Mom! You're
coming.
Mom, what's the matter?
You've insulted your father.
You've insulted my father.
Well, in that case, I'll leave you.
Sit the f*** down. You're not gonna leave until you see what's deep inside of you.
What are you gonna do? Kill me? Help! Help!
Help! Help! Help!
How now? A rat?
We're rolling. Save me, and hover over me with your wings, your heavenly guards. But would your gracious figure do not come, your tidy son to chide, that lapsed in time and passion, let go by the importance of acting in your dread command. Oh, say!
Who the f*** are you talking to?
To him! Look how pale he is! Look, he goes at the door!
You're hallucinating.
I am not hallucinating. My heart beats the same as yours, mother. For love and grace, lay not in a flattering unaction to your soul, and then not your trespass, but by madness speaks. It bulb but skin in the film of ulcerous place, whilst the ray corruption, mining all within, infects the unseen. Confess yourself to heaven.
Look in my heart in two.
Oh, throw away the worser part of it, and live the pure in the other half. Good night, but don't go to my uncle's bed. Refrain tonight. I'll deal with this.
This is the end. Hold your breath and count to 10. Feel the earth move and then hear my heart burst again. For this is the end. I've drowned and dreamt this morning.